Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Monday Night Raw. What a show we have for you tonight in our third episode, so stay tuned. It's going to get wild. So last week, we had three great matches for you. Our main event decided who Darth Maul's opponent is going to be at Extreme Rules in 2 weeks. Now, we've yet to see Darth Maul compete yet on Raw, but I am here to tell you that next week, Darth Maul will be making his debut on Monday Night Raw 1 week ahead of his first title defense against Dr. Doom. So next week, Darth Maul will be in action. This week, we have a loaded card for you this evening. In our main event is a six-man over-the-top rope battle royal. The winner of that match will go on to Extreme Rules to face Skeletor for the Intercontinental Championship. So we have not seen Skeletor compete yet either, but his opponent at Extreme Rules will be decided tonight. Six men have the opportunity to earn that title match. Also, in our co-main event of the night is the rematch that we've all been waiting for over the last 2 weeks. Goku and Dr. Doom. Remember, Dr. Doom got that title shot opportunity last week by beating Bane. He had a promo earlier in the night where he was kind of talking about his match with Goku. Goku came out, assaulted Dr. Doom. Well, those two are going to get a chance to settle it tonight in an Extreme Rules matchup. So anything will go between those two tonight as they look to bring some closure to their little rivalry. Or potentially not. We'll see. We'll have to see what Goku's going to do. But first off tonight here on Raw, we have one of the members of the industry, Drake, facing off with Michael Jackson. So remember, Mike Squared on week one of Raw actually beat the tag team champions here, Lil Wayne and Drake. Now we have a singles contest. I'm also here to inform you that Mike Squared will be getting an opportunity at the tag team championships in 2 weeks at Extreme Rules. So our Extreme Rules card is starting to really take shape here, and an opportunity once again for Mike Squared, or in this case Michael Jackson, to take advantage here against one of the members of the industry. And it is going to be Michael Jackson picking up a huge victory. So Mike Squared has the industry's number right now. They better watch out 2 weeks ahead of their matchup where they will put the WWE tag team titles on the line. Next up in the women's division, we have Hillary Clinton making her debut here on Raw. Last week, Catwoman had a huge match with the women's champion in a non-title match, Harley Quinn. That was a great matchup. Catwoman really impressing a lot of people here. She will get another opportunity to potentially get her first win here on Raw against Hillary, and it's going to be Hillary Clinton picking up a big victory there over Catwoman. So, Catwoman now dropping two matches in a row, despite looking very impressive. So we'll have to see what is in store for her future and for Hillary after picking up her first victory here on Raw. So next up, tag team division. We have a brand new tag team making their debut here on Raw. They're going by the name World Class, meaning they are two world-class athletes, and indeed they are. Kobe Bryant and Lionel Messi will be facing off with Barney and Shrek. So we will see tag team action here. We already know who's getting the opportunity at those titles in 2 weeks, but doesn't hurt to pick up some victories here. And it's going to be Barney and Shrek. So the new team still working it out together, but for right now, impressive there. Remember, Shrek last week picked up a singles victory, now picking up a tag team victory with his partner Barney. So, we are going to jump right in here. It looks like the man who lost an opportunity to go for the Universal Championship at Extreme Rules, Bane, will be coming out to speak with these fans in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. So, let's jump in and hear what Bane has to say.
Hey
So Bane, presumably not very happy after last week's loss against Dr. Doom, in which he failed to capitalize on his opportunity to get a WWE Universal Championship match against Darth Maul. So out here tonight to speak with these fans here in Toronto. Let's listen in and hear what he has to say.
2 weeks ago on Raw, I had a match with Harambe, a match in which I was the victor. But last week, when I faced off with Dr. Doom, a chance at the Universal Championship on the line, I fell short. Now, I should take the loss and accept it for what it is. However, I am not willing to do so, because the Universal Championship is the only thing that matters to me. So regardless of the outcome of the match at Extreme Rules between Darth Maul and Dr. Doom, just know that the following night on Monday Night Raw, I will be there, and I will be waiting for the Universal Champion. Oh yes, I will be waiting, and the true champion will...
What the hell is this? Darth Maul, our champion, coming out! Darth Maul making his first appearance here on Raw! The Universal Champion coming out, answering Bane's calls here. The fans here in Toronto going absolutely crazy.
Hello, Bane. I couldn't stand to stand back there any more and listen to you run your mouth about my Universal Championship. I just want you to know that in 2 weeks at Extreme Rules, I will be walking out as champion. And if you are going to be there waiting for me on Monday night, then I will be ready for you.
We will see about that, Maul. We will see on that fateful Monday night.
I very much look forward to that.
I don't think that you will be saying that come 2 weeks from now. Surely you do not know what is coming for you.
Maybe that is so. But I am the champion, and I will not be intimidated by you.
So Darth Maul making his first appearance here on Raw, having a little chat there with Bane. So clearly Bane unhappy with that loss last week, still wants a shot at the champ, but as for right now, it will be Dr. Doom getting that opportunity, and now we get to see Dr. Doom back in action this week. As you see his opponent, Goku, coming to the ring right now. These two have been going back and forth. Remember, they had an incredible match in the first episode here of Raw. Last week, Goku not done with Dr. Doom following that loss. Now he will get another opportunity here on Raw in an Extreme Rules match. So these men do not like each other. They will have an opportunity to pull out all the stops to inflict pain on one another tonight. Goku looking very ready here as we await the number one contender. Dr. Doom coming to the ring with that baseball bat, which he may have an opportunity to use here against Goku tonight. So an unblemished record here on Raw for Dr. Doom. He is 2-0 against two very, very talented opponents, and he will get a shot at another, or I should say rather, he will get another shot at the one that he beat the first week of Raw in Goku. So starting out right away, going after Goku, but now Goku's not going to waste any time. You know that he was ready and waiting for this match. Waiting for an opportunity to inflict some pain on Dr. Doom, but as for right now, those efforts, we're going to have to wait. The sledgehammer sitting here on the outside. There are no countouts in this match. These men will have to beat each other senseless until one of them can continue no more. You see Dr. Doom's head sent off of that turnbuckle post. And now right here by the announce table, Goku gonna look for a fisherman suplex, but it's blocked here. Dr. Doom with a big right hook. Rolling through and a big DDT on the outside. Head into this outside concrete area. The number one contender looking very impressive once again here tonight. I think Darth Maul is going to have his hands full with Dr. Doom in 2 weeks, but you also have to wonder what kind of damage is going to be done to Dr. Doom in this match. Is he even going to be 100% in 2 weeks? If Goku has his way, he certainly will not be. But right now, Dr. Doom in control of this match. Still over here by the announce table. And a huge flip there. Dr. Doom's back hitting that barricade. And a jumping leg drop there from Goku on the outside. And now he's going to grab the sledgehammer. Goku going to look to inflict some pain here, but Dr. Doom avoids that for the time being. A big right hook to the kidneys. And now sending Goku's head off of the barricade. And now they're going into the crowd. Dr. Doom with a huge forearm sending Goku into the crowd, and here they go. These fans here in Toronto getting a little bit of an extra show here. There's a headbutt and they continue to move further back into the depths of this arena here tonight in the Air Canada Center. Fireman's carry. Now that ground over there, that is not padded. Our floor here around the ring is padded. This is straight concrete that these superstars are now fighting on. Big knee to the head there, Dr. Doom. And like I said, what kind of condition is Dr. Doom going to leave tonight with? Tripping Goku there. He's going to go for a half Boston Crab here on the outside. Remember, this match can end over here in the crowd. Pinfalls, submissions, that can all occur outside of the ring. A big headbutt. These men continue to go back and forth. Goku gonna look for a sidewalk slam, but it's blocked there by Dr. Doom. And now he's gonna roll through and hit a huge powerbomb there. And a rolling powerbomb right on the concrete. The back of Goku's head, I think, hit off of that cement floor. And he is out cold. The Super Saiyan is out cold on the outside, and he's just starting to get back to his feet here. And Dr. Doom gonna come back for more. And there's a huge headbutt. Dr. Doom's body like a weapon in itself. Continuing to assault Goku. But here comes Goku with a couple of right hands. And an uppercut there from the Super Saiyan. But right back with a right forearm. These two men going back and forth yet again, just like their first matchup. Dr. Doom on the offensive here with these huge hooks, and Goku is just getting battered. But look at this. Goku gonna look for a huge gut buster on the outside. And this may be what he needed to get back into this match. And now he's gonna grab a chair. Goku has a chair, looking to inflict some serious damage on Dr. Doom with a huge chair shot to the top of the head. And another one from Goku. Just assaulting Dr. Doom with that chair. And you know that that feels good for Goku. Been waiting for 2 weeks to get some revenge here. And getting a chance to do it in a big way. Now Dr. Doom looking to head back to the ring. He wants to get away from all of these weapons that are surrounding these two men here. He doesn't want to take any more chair blows to the head. And now it looks like Goku is going to come back inside here. Throwing Dr. Doom, and we are back in the ring here. Huge elbows from Dr. Doom, but a huge right hand, sending Dr. Doom flying to the mat. And a Kamehameha attempt is blocked, and now it looks like he's going to go for a Doomsday. No, he's going to go for a powerbomb instead. And he's going to go for the cover here. And there's that powerbomb maneuver. That same powerbomb maneuver that we saw in the first contest between these two. Dr. Doom switching out of that cover into a submission hold. Thought he might be looking for a Doomsday after that Kamehameha. Now he's going to go for a cover here. Two. And a kick out at two from Goku. Both men badly hurt, I think, in this matchup so far. I think that Kamehameha, remember, Dr. Doom kicked out of two of them in the first matchup between these two, but after those chair blows, I think that one would have sent the number one contender away here tonight, but huge counter there. Now Goku gonna look for some more weapons, and he's got Dr. Doom's bat. Goku has Dr. Doom's bat, and he takes a running strike at him and misses. Now hits him with a DDT here. So remember, I said that Dr. Doom may have an opportunity to use that bat here tonight against Goku, but looks like Goku's going to try and use his own weapon against him. And now Goku's starting to feel it a little bit here tonight. And now Goku might be setting up for a Kamehameha. And is this gonna be it? One, two, and a kick out at 2.5. Oh my God. Dr. Doom can just not be put away here on Raw. And there's that ducking lariat. The signature ducking lariat that put Goku away in their first matchup. And Dr. Doom with some huge strikes to the face. And will he be looking for a Doomsday here? Goku with a big counter there. Now he's going to go for a cover. Can he steal one? One, two, kick out at two. So the bat's still laying in the ring here, unused so far. And now Dr. Doom's setting up here for a huge powerbomb! What a maneuver! And Goku is badly hurt here. He is not moving. And a ducking lariat once again. That might do it if he decides to go for a cover here. He will not, and Goku's going to get back into this. Flipping Dr. Doom now, going for a cover here. Two. Kick out at two from Dr. Doom. I think if he'd have gone for a cover there after that lariat, that might have been it. But potentially looking for a doomsday, and now he's going to look for it. He's got Goku up. Can he send him? There it is. Doomsday from Dr. Doom. And he is very weak here, can barely even stand to go for this cover. One, two, and a kick out at 2.5. Oh my God. Unbelievable from Goku. This match is living up to the hype. Part two between Dr. Doom and Goku, it might even be better than the first. This is incredible. What a matchup here on Monday Night Raw. These two men putting on a show in front of these fans here tonight. And now Goku, after taking a huge doomsday, which I thought was certainly enough to do it, given the amount of pain that has been inflicted on Goku thus far in this match. But it was not enough. And now Dr. Doom pacing here, waiting for Goku to get up. Will he be looking for another doomsday here? Goku is looking very disoriented. And he is crawling. He is crawling to try and get out of the ring here. There goes the baseball bat. And there's a fireman's carry, and Dr. Doom kind of caught up in the corner there. And now Goku setting up for another Kamehameha. Can he get him? One, two, three. And Goku has finally done it. Unbelievable match from these two tonight. The number one contender, Dr. Doom, 2-0 on Raw. Kicked out of one Kamehameha. Goku lands the second one, and unlike 2 weeks ago, that put him away. And like I said, what kind of condition is Dr. Doom in after that contest? Now just 2 weeks away from a title opportunity, Dr. Doom might be in a lot of trouble here. And Goku, absolutely incredible here from Goku. What a victory for the Super Saiyan here on Monday Night Raw. So absolutely unbelievable match we just saw between Dr. Doom and Goku. Unbelievable, but now we gotta switch gears here. We're going to a six-man battle royal. Winner getting an opportunity at the Intercontinental Championship. Very prestigious title here on Raw. A lot of the men in this match will be making their first appearance here on Raw. One of them being the man we are seeing right now, Deadpool. So a huge opportunity here for one of these men to go on to face Skeletor in 2 weeks at Extreme Rules. Next up, who's it gonna be here? It's here comes Scorpion. Scorpion had a matchup with Spider-Man in week one, matchup in which he lost. Now getting an opportunity here. Spider-Man will also be involved in this contest. And here he comes. So Spider-Man, Scorpion, and Deadpool thus far. Here is Ash Ketchum. Though Ash was also in action on week one, failed to pick up a victory, but has an opportunity here tonight. The young trainer from Palatown fired up for this matchup here. And Minecraft Steve, a fan favorite here on Raw. Can Steve be the one to pull off a huge victory here? Would be a crazy upset if Steve were able to do it. And our final competitor in tonight's Battle Royal, Captain Jack Sparrow. So these six men all have an opportunity to compete, or to rather earn themselves a chance to compete against Skeletor in 2 weeks for the Intercontinental Championship. This will be an over-the-top battle royal. All five of the losing superstars will have to be sent over the top rope and have both feet hit the ground, leaving with one victor. And who is it gonna be? So here we go. Six men. One will be left standing. And let's get it started. So right away here, we see each competitor kind of choosing one of their opponents for the time being. Spider-Man working on Ash Ketchum right now. So just as with Darth Maul. We have not seen Skeletor compete yet on Raw. But in 2 weeks, he will put his championship belt on the line. And here comes Steve with an Irish whip. Scorpion on the outside. Now Jack Sparrow on the outside here. Deadpool. Now we have three men on the apron. And Spider-Man better hang on here. And for the time being, all men are safe. Now Ash Ketchum with none of his Pokemon here to help him tonight. Steve and Deadpool on the apron right now. Will we see an elimination? Deadpool is safe. Steve also safe for the time being. Going for a belly to belly there in Scorpion. So ladies and gentlemen, I should also announce at this time that General Manager Jesus Christ has made a match at Extreme Rules. Last week, Harley Quinn called out Nicki Minaj here on Raw. That match will be held in 2 weeks for the Women's Championship. Harley Quinn against Nicki Minaj. So Nicki Minaj will have an opportunity to bring another title belt into the industry, but remember, Drake and Lil Wayne have a title match. They will need to retain those belts if the industry want to be a perfect 4-for-4 in terms of championships. There's a huge crossbody by Spider-Man here. Deadpool hanging on with one hand there, but Jack Sparrow not done with him. Still no eliminations yet here tonight. All of these superstars very hungry for an opportunity at the Intercontinental Championship. Now Steve gonna go to the top rope. That's a risky move here. Luckily was not pushed off, but he did not hit that diving splash attempt either. And now Steve on the apron. But it looks like Ash and Spider-Man getting in the way there before Scorpion could get to Steve. Now Ash working on Spider-Man here. Scorpion working on Steve. And once again, we have three superstars in danger! And we have a double elimination! Spider-Man and Steve going out at the same time, and now Jack Sparrow being dumped. A triple team effort. So just like that, we have been cut in half here. Six turns into three. What a turn of events here in the main event of Raw. And now Ash gonna sit back here and let these two men work on each other. And now we're gonna take advantage of a downed Scorpion here. Deadpool gonna stand back using some strategy here. Trying to stay as fresh as possible. And now Scorpion gonna look to get back into things, and Deadpool's not gonna allow that. Deadpool got Scorpion on the apron here. Might get Ash to help him out here if Ash can get to his feet. And Ash gonna stand and watch here. Not looking to get involved. Maybe thinks Deadpool may turn on him. Scorpion here being bombarded. A 2-on-1 assault. And now Deadpool and Ash working together here. So clearly an alliance has formed here between Ash and Deadpool, but Scorpion still trying to keep himself in this match, and now it looks like he's going to send Ash flying over the top ropes, and Ash's feet nearly touching. And now Scorpion back in trouble here, and Ash going to stand and watch once again. Gotta wonder A double team there might certainly get enough force to get Scorpion pushed off the apron, but... And now Deadpool looking to be in trouble, and now look at this! So after it seemed as though Ash and Deadpool had formed an alliance, quickly Ash turning on his little partner there, and then a huge maneuver by Ash. And now Deadpool going after Ash here as Scorpion crawls to his feet. What a night here on Monday Night Raw. Ash looking for a roll up there, but not going to get a pinfall in this match. And now Scorpion getting tossed over once again. Scorpion just not giving up here in this match. How many times has he been sent over the ropes and hung on for dear life? Great resiliency shown by Scorpion in this contest, and now getting back into things here, and it looks like Deadpool and Scorpion might be double teaming on Ash here. But Ash gonna get right back in the ring, but Deadpool got him locked up here. Big Russian leg sweep there. So which one of these men is gonna move on for a chance at Skeletor's championship? Huge elbow there from Deadpool. Ash might have been unconscious there for a second. Continuing to attack the head here. But now Ash, jawbreaker there, getting back into things, but Scorpion's not going to let that happen. Now Ash seems to be the target here. Can he find a way? Just getting assaulted. And now Deadpool, it looked like Scorpion might have hit Deadpool with a right hook accidentally, and Deadpool took a little offense to that. And now backing off once again as Scorpion hits a huge neck breaker there. And Ash's lifeless carcass being dragged to the center of the ring. No Charmander, no Squirtle, and no Snorlax here tonight to help out Ash. And now though, had Scorpion in a little bit of trouble, and now it looks like Scorpion might be targeted again here. Deadpool, but gonna be shoved away there. So after three quick eliminations, these three men battling here for an opportunity at the Intercontinental Championship. Huge clothesline there. Nearly taking Ash's head off. And Ash hanging on with one hand. Managing to get back in the ring. Back of the head sent off of Deadpool's knee there. And Scorpion still taking a lot of damage in this match. A dropping elbow there and a kip up from Deadpool. A little bit of showmanship there. Now Scorpion sent out onto the apron. Deadpool's got him locked up. Is this going to be it for Scorpion? And it will be. So two men remain in this matchup. Two men that had temporarily formed an alliance in this contest. And Deadpool has Ash on the ropes here. Is this going to be it? And Deadpool has done it. So a huge victory here for Deadpool. And he will be going on to face Skeletor in 2 weeks with some championship gold on the line. What a match here tonight. Ash Ketchum showing a lot of heart here. Sticking in till the very end, but Deadpool is going to walk away victorious here tonight. So huge victory here. What a show we had tonight. Goku picking up a victory over the number one contender for the Universal title. Deadpool earning an opportunity for the Intercontinental title, and a few other matches made for our pay-per-view Extreme Rules in 2 weeks. So next week, one more Raw until we hit our first pay-per-view. So what's going to happen? Stay tuned. Tune in next week on Raw.